Okay. Good everyone. Good morning everyone. Okay. Today we talk about improve container networking performance with the BGP. I'm Jirapat. Yeah, I'm from Nepal Cloud in Thailand.
Hello, my name is Patim Bulat from Nepal Cloud too. Another guy sitting in front of us today is Mr. Chan Sin. He is a chair of innovation officer backing up two of us. Okay, let's start.
Okay, agenda for today is we will talk about our environment and consideration when we deploy Kubernetes on the OpenStack in the public cloud service. Yeah. Next, we talk about port-to-port networks improvement. Basically, is IP and IP modes encapsulation between the worker node on top of the OpenStack, right? And next, we will talk about Kubernetes service, IP advertising with the BGP, and intercluster with the BGP. And the last, we talk about feature work. Yep, next.
Yes, let me get into the first topic of agenda. Our Kubernetes environment is take place on our OpenStack public cloud. We utilize OpenStack Victoria integrated with SDN Tungsten Fabric as a Newton plugin. Using Launcher RKE1 and Calico CNI on every setup, our cluster integrated with the OpenStack API allow us to enjoy several benefits. Firstly, we can leverage persistent volume from Cinder. Secondly, is access to load balancer from Octavia load balancer. And lastly, we have ability to scale our cluster up or down with just a single click. By combining the power of Kubernetes and capability of OpenStack, we have created a robust and scalable for our Kubernetes environment. Due to the fact we run Kubernetes cluster on OpenStack, created using the launcher API call into OpenStack, we obtain Kubernetes node as instant running on multiple compute node. In the OpenStack compute node, we may already be a network underlay utilizing VXLAN encapsulation between the compute node. In the left picture, we will show you about when port A communication with port B. The port A on the worker A in the compute A need to communication with another port in worker B in a compute B. The first issue we encounter is a double encapsulation. That packet need to be encapsulated twice. The first encapsulated is IP in IP at the worker level, and second encapsulation at a VXLAN in the compute node of OpenStack. This process of decapsulation rely on the CPU to perform the encapsulation. The second issue we identify is that the throughput for port-to-port communication across different port is not optimal. We conducted tests using the IPERP-T to evaluate the communication between the port. Okay, next.
Okay, you know when we need to access to the application when you run inside the Kubernetes cluster, we need the dedicated external router for the communication to back in port on the worker node, right? But we have some the consideration and some the issue like you know is load balancer is work in the active passive mode, right? This is a have some issue botanics rely on the only one node. Yeah. And need to be use a VRP for check the state between the active and passive node, right? And then if we run on the bare metal, if you have a issue about looping inside the layer 2 network, is have the impact to the work to the load balancer work. Yeah. Okay. Next.
And the last consideration is intercommunication elasticity. We have multiple Kubernetes cluster for each team responsible for managing their respective cluster. However, we want curtain application to be able to communicate with another application across Kubernetes cluster, allowing them to share some service without external load balancer. So we would like to grouping the improvement topic as follows. The first one is port-to-port network improvement. The second is service IP improvement. And the last is across cluster improvement. Okay, let's start in the first one. Port-to-port network improvement we will describe in Kubernetes basic network tuning. Consist of MTU jumbo frame using Kuproxy IPvS instead of IP table, Calico BGP peering mode, and the last is Calico overlay network. Okay, let's start. In the first is MTU jumbo frame. By default, Calico CNI has a default MTU that work on various cloud provider, but it may not suitable for every cloud environment. The first task after I set up Kubernetes cluster is configure the MTU jumbo frame for suitable network on OpenStack cloud environment. This adjustment helps reduce CPU loss caused by doing the packet fragmentation and improve throughput during port-to-port communication. The left below picture is a comparison before versus after testing using the IPERP tree. After we set the MTU, we test port-to-port throughput is upper from 3.6 gigabit per sec to 9.6 gigabit per sec on one type of our compute favor. And the second, the light side is second consideration is a Kuproxy. In the Calico documentation, it is recommended to use IPvS mode instead of IP table mode. IPvS specialize in technology of load balancing, offering better performance in hashing and lower CPU usage. Additionally, it provides more load balancer algorithm. The lastly, IPvS mode handle loop more efficiently in the last cluster with the malice of service and policy when they updating a new rule or policy. Okay, next. Next slide is Calico BGP peering mode. Starting with the left side. When created, the Kubernetes cluster with Calico CNI selected. The default behavior, the Calico is perform BGP with node-to-node full mesh. This means that every node needs to be paired with the other node to broadcast loud. However, as our cluster going up to include over 100 or 200 of nodes, we may find that this way is no longer scalable because cannot increase the number of BGP peer in the cluster. The second, the solution is on the right side. Loudly vector topology, we use BGP loudly vector is a mechanism to overcome the requirement of 8-bit establish a full-fledged IBGP and provide all IBGP routing information to all IBGP peer. In my setup, I group the team master node to function as a load reflector server, wiring all worker node act as a load reflector client. As a result, worker node no longer needs to establish direct connection with every other node. They only need to establish connection with the master node. This approach reduce both bandwidth usage and CPU load in the BGP topology. Okay, next.
Okay. You know when the port-to-port communication between the worker node, the default or Calico is use IP in IP mode, right? This is need the encapsulation and decapsulation when packet align on the worker node. In our environment, we use a tungsten fabric. Yeah. Huh? Do you know tungsten fabric? Show your hand up. Okay, right. Okay. So we need to reduce decap and encap for the CPU efficiency on the worker node. Above the picture, this is a use a IP and AEP mode. You will see the CNI of a port is worker node, right? And the next hop is a tunnel zero. That means is a encapsulation when the port communication to port, yeah. And then we reduce the CPU usage for decap and encap with a core subnet mode, right? Calico is a mean is if we have a worker node in the same layer 2, right? When the port communication to port different, the worker node is not needs a decap or encapsulation yet, right? You will see the above picture. This is a CIDR of a port is node. We are now in a ETH 0. Yeah, that mean is not decap and encapsulation when the port to port. Yeah, next. Okay, next. Okay, we will talk about why we use a service IP with the BGP. Why we not use a dedicated load balancer for the external access to this application, right? Okay, this is a benefit of when we use the service IP with the BGP. First, not need the external load balancer, right? And then it support the EcoCore multipart, yeah, or the ECMP load balancing, and support when you need to the control traffic with the BGP attribute, like AHPart pipe to control the ingress traffic, right? And local pipeline can control the egress. Yeah. And the last, the short IP is preservation is not need net, right? We can send the packet to the monitoring system or the security system to analyze. This is a benefit for ours. Yep. Before we start ECMP, ECMP multipart, we need to know the default inside a Linux kernel. We have a three, but the default is a hashing policy is 0. It's hashing with the two tuple. That means it's a user short IP and destination IP to hashing, right? And second, at below picture is a use a five tuple. That's a hashing policy is set 0. Set to 1. The five tuple is hash with the short IP address, destination IP address, IP protocol, and sort port and destination port. That is a better hashing when we compare the two tuple. In our environment, we set to the five tuple. Yeah. And next, we need to the to router for the PRBGP with the Calico inside the Kubernetes for the redundant, and it's at the active mode, right? And we need to the config IP pool for allow external prefix into the Kubernetes. Yeah. And the last, we should select the service mode like a cluster or the local. In our example, we use the local and select the load balancer. Yeah. And if you select external traffic policy is local, you only or must be select type load balancer or the node port. Yeah. Next. For the PoC, yeah, this is a picture. We have two internet gateway, XS like top of rack or the GR. Yeah. Oh, sorry. This is a connect to the upstream provider. Yeah. And in the gray box, this is inside the OpenStack. And we have three nodes at the BGP error service. Yeah. We use the VYOS and PFSense to access this layer. Yes. And three BGP as with PRBGP with IBGP to keep routing from the internet gateway and from the Kubernetes. Yeah. And the master node is at the route restrictor server. When the route restrictor server is receive route from the BGP error service, is advertising route to the worker node, and worker node is at route restrictor client. Yeah. Okay, this is show example about configuration POC. Yeah. This is enabled, must be enabled the ECMP part on the BGP address service. Yeah, this is a configuration of VYOS. And then we need to the configuration inside the Kubernetes with the route restrictor cluster ID to the grouping a master node, three nodes, add the route restrictor cluster. Yeah. And next, we need to configuration the IP pool for the CIDR for allow the external prefix from the BGP to the Kubernetes service. Yep. And the next, we need to we configuration the key original NetHop is to that mean like a NetHop cell inside the Cisco or Juniper or the Arista. Yeah. To advertise out to the worker node have to see the NetHop is from the BGP address service. Yeah. And the last external traffic load balancer is a local using to the load balancer type. Yeah. Okay. This is a result of the PUC. This is we use a Nginx. And the tie load balancer and external IP. This is a privacy for the POC. And above picture, this is a show on the BGP address service. Receive a service IP from the Kubernetes, and you can see the file NetHop on this. That means it's ECMP is enabled. Next. And if we show in the worker node, you will see the external prefix received from the BGP address service and see to the three network to a load balancing. Yeah, that means it support ECMP, and the above is can the access from the client. That's mean. Yeah.
Okay, from the previous topic, we will talk about the topic in intercommunication to cluster with BGP. In this topic, we will showcase our use case for integration Kubernetes with router and connect to cluster using BGP. Start with the goal of this solution. We mentioned you before, we have multiple Kubernetes cluster for each dedicated to specific operator or application. One of our requirement is to enable communication between application across different cluster and provide in-case for access from internet. From the diagram, we have the router on the top and the main cluster. I exhibit the main cluster act as an external inbound load. It's in-case for every team and every cluster used together. Our solution for implement is configure the Calico configuration resource to tell bird establish a BGP peer between the main cluster and the cloud router. This allows us to advertise service IP address used for the service IP and load balancer in the in-case software. When user access our website or backend application, the traffic will send directly from the internet to the router, and is only routed to the worker node where the in-case port are running. And look in the below cluster is another Kubernetes cluster. The cluster I mentioned below is a cluster where variant application running on. Such as a backend or website are running on them. To enable access to this application to the load balancer, we utilize BERT to establish peer between the main cluster and below cluster. Using the eBGP, by giving that the master node have fixed IP address and they will suit to serve a BGP node and establish a peer mesh between two cluster. Furthermore, configure the BGP configuration to advertise the service IP to main cluster for proper routing. By we implement this solution, we gain the following the benefit. The first is utilization of only the single public IP address for advertising to the router, allow for ECMP path selection, high availability, and eliminating the bottleneck of a single node active load balancer. No longer need to manage an external load balancer or dealing with complexity of the underlying network. And the last is simplification of the in-case layer, as there is no longer need to access the public service to the multiple in-case layer. Okay, next.
Okay, the last section is talk about feature work. Yeah. Okay, I'm Nipakao. Nipakao is a cloud service provider in Thailand. We will provide a feature for support in our customer like Kubernetes, right? And then we will provide two options for them. First, we provide the Octavia load balancer integrated with the Kubernetes. And second, we will provide the BGP address service for the integrate with the Kube service AP, right? And right now we will deploy the BGP as a service and sales service on the our platform and deploy the internet gateway router to integrate with the BGP as a service and deploy the public pool for the Kubernetes IP service with the multi-tenancy. And the last, we will improve the compute ability to act as a network service, accelerated network performance like with the DPDK or the SIV and SmartNIC. Yep. The answer. Yep. Do you have any question? Yeah.
I have a question. Have you managed to solve the problem of losing sessions when the when changing the members of a load balancer set? So if you remove one of your workers, now all your hashes change and traffic gets redirected. Have you managed to solve that with anything?
Do you mean the section when we are with the BGP address with and go to the direct to the port, right? About the BBGP, you know when the traffic load balance with the ECMP, right? We not control the traffic, but we can control with the BGP attribute like local preference or the eighth party pin. If we have a T node, right? The ECMP is formed go to the internet gateway, right? Hatching with the handle with the node 1, node 2, node 3, or node 2, right? If we need to the control traffic, we can use a ASPath pipeline, have people prefer to the BGP 1 or 2, and then we will maintain the node. Yeah. And I think it's so very fast when the detection when we compare with the traditional load balancer when we use the VRP detection. Yep. Okay. Any question?
Can you scale down more? Can you scale up to like say it's two clusters? Can you go more than two clusters or multiple clusters? Is that something that was tested on the
roadmap? Cluster in you mean Kubernetes cluster, right? If you remember in the slide, yeah, when we peering the BGP address service to the only the master node, yeah, the master node at the Lowry vector server, right? I think is if we scale the worker node, this not need to the reconfiguration or more additional configuration BGP between the Kubernetes and the BGP as a service because master node is act at the Lowry vector server and propagate Low receive from the BGP as a service to the worker node and then it's a key original network to the BGP as a service and T node. Any question? Okay, thanks so much.
Thank you
for joining us.